Second play of the game, Bill Osmanski drives away for the Bears. Watch now as Chicago's George Wilson takes out not one, but two Redskins. And
3 hours, the Bears beat the Redskins like no team has ever been beaten, starting on the game's second play.
The captain of the team was George Wilson, our right end. He came all the way over to the left sideline, and as the two Redskin players were coming, he hit them with probably the hardest block I think I may have ever seen. He knocked them up in the air. In fact, when the game was over, George's wife said, "My goodness gracious, who was that man that hit those people? He didn't even know. It's my husband couldn't do that. Nobody hits people that hard, especially George might." Well, it was just the block of all blocks.
The Bears played the game of all games, scoring 21 points in the game's first 13 minutes, and spent most of the second half body-slamming future Hall of Fame quarterback Sammy Ball.
And my job is to rush the passer, mainly as a defensive end. In the event that the fullback swung out my way, I was to drop off and cover.
Hampton Poole's interception return for a touchdown started the second half scoring frenzy. In all, 10 Bears would score 11 touchdowns, including this gem by Bulldog Turner.
Back in those days, now you kick the ball, and when you kick the ball into the crowd, that was the end of the ball. You wouldn't get it back.
It was the T formation with a man in motion at his best.
It was also the most lopsided score in NFL history.
But, you know, those are the things you dream about.
Incredibly, the Monsters of the Midway were masters of the NFL for the third time in 4 years. In 1946, the war was over. Papa Bear was back prowling the sidelines, and the Bears romped their way to another title, whipping the Giants. 4 World Championships in 7 seasons made the Bears the league's first ever dynasty. What heights they might have achieved without the war will never be known.
And you know, we won 4 World Championships in 6 years, and the thing that was devastating was that the war broke us up. The Monsters of the Midway, they were rough, they were tough, they were mean, and they were cruel, but they were so wonderful.
Frank in motion again, takes a handoff from Philchak, goes around the right side, gets up to the 34-yard line, fumbles the ball, and it is going to be recovered by the Bears. Luckman back to pass. He's looking downfield, throws down the middle, and between the goalposts, Kenny Kavanaugh makes the catch. It's a Bear touchdown. 7-0 Bears, back to pass, goes Philchak. Sprinkle comes in, almost takes his head off, throws the ball down the middle. Magnotti intercepts at the 37, Donnie's at the 30, the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10, the 5, and it's Bears 13-0. He's back to pass, gets good protection, and he throws downfield for libel, and McAfee cuts in front of him, intercepts at the 47, gets leveled at the 50, gets back up, and gets pushed out of bounds on 1st and 10 from 43. Philchak throwing for Livingston, over his head, and intercepted by McAfee at the 21, and he comes back to the 27-yard line. Luckman fakes to McAfee, cuts inside of McCaffrey, he's gonna run the ball. He's at the 15, he's at the 10, bulls his way down to the 5, and into the end zone. It's a touchdown for the Bears. On 3rd and 6, Philchak gets the snap, fades to pass. He throws out to the left. It's intercepted by Bulldog Turner right in his hands. He's down to the 35, cuts inside, eludes Coulter, gets down to the 25 and over the 25. 1st and 10 from the 26. And Philchak again going back to pass, throws a screen pass, falls incomplete. Philchak throwing on almost every down now, and he is bulldogged down by Ed Sprinkle. And the snap goes back to Philchak. He's rolling right. He's being chased by Fred Davis. And he throws long downfield, aimed at Jack Meade. Intercepted by Luckman, who leaped up to make the interception. And he muscles his way back up to the 34-yard line.